Ladies and gentlemen, it's Super Late Night with celebrity guest Joaquine Phoenix, comedic musical guest Mr. Mohino, and the Super Late Night band, the Pantalones, and your host of the show, Patrick Sutherland.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, fine. I know. You love me. You want me to just stand here and look pretty. Thank you. Thank you. Folks, we've got a lot to talk about tonight. A lot of funny things in the news. We've got a great show for you tonight. Some very talented guests. First of all, I want to talk about, in the news, Dolly Parton and Pamela Anderson were seen dancing to a slow dance in a bar in Texas. Okay? Pretty funny stuff. To some onlookers, it looked like a very beautiful, romantic sight. And to others, it looked like two toothpicks and four grapes. Which is very interesting. Pedro, how was the weekend?
The weekend was fantastic, senor. I had a hot date.
So you had a good date? The date was good?
Yeah, I like my women like I like my tacos.
And how was that?
Hot and spicy.
Yeah, well, I like my women like I like my hamburgers. Beefy with nice buns. Oh, man. What else is in the news? Do you guys remember the ShamWow guy on the ShamWow commercial? He was selling basic paper towel for 30 bucks. That guy, crazy hair. He actually got an altercation with a pimp, ended up punching the pimp in the nose, making his nose bleed. Yeah. Then afterward, the ShamWow guy felt bad, offer him a ShamWow to clean up his nose. You know? Very nice. There's a statistic out there right now where there are numerous women nursing their children on their breast, obviously, until 5 years old. 5 years old. Can you imagine? Wait, just to keep the baby fat off, because apparently you burn calories by nursing, you know? There are other alternatives to embarrassing your poor little child. He's going to be playing street hockey out in the driveway. He's going to text his mom, "Mom, I'm pretty thirsty. Can you get her ready?" He's going to run inside. His buddy's going to be right behind him going, "Can I get a sip, too?" My wife of almost 2 years, yeah, thank you, just accepted me as a friend on Facebook for the very first time, which is kind of funny. Just accepted me as a friend for the first time. But now she's really mad at me because I've been poking all her friends, you know? You just can't win. And her sister, her mom, and her cousin, Jim. So, whatever, you know, come on. But anyways, folks, have a great show for you tonight. Joaquine Phoenix is on the show. Musical guest Mr. Mohino is on the show. And ladies and gentlemen, we cannot forget the best band in the world, the Super Late Night Pantalones. Folks, here at Super Late Night, we like to go out and about in the cities we visit and visit with the locals and ask them questions about current events and reward them if they have correct and if they're up to speed with current events, and if they're not, with the same time, like to punish them. I have to call this segment Box Your Ears Off. Take a look. Can you please tell me the name of the most recent elected U.S. president?
I would be...
Can you tell me who the primary sponsor was for the Tim Hortons Briar? Name four current Canadian prime ministers?
Harper, Chrétien, Martin, Trudeau.
Excellent work. Excellent work. Here's $5.
Thank you very much. I'm gonna mess around. Name a fifth.
Okay. Can you tell me who the old guy was that ran against U.S. President Barack Obama in the U.S. election race and his female sidekick?
John McCain and Veronica...
Can you name one of the reasons for the U.S. recession?
I believe that was mortgage foreclosures.
What is the name of the street that Stephen Harper lives on?
That would be 1022 Sex Drive.
What's your name?
Mike.
I usually pronounce my name twice when I say it too. Patrick. What two opposition leaders in Canadian government tried to oust Stephen Harper?
Jack Layton and Stephane Dion.
Very good. There's $5 for you, sir. Yeah. Can you describe the chemical formula for pie?
For pie?
Pretend you're thinking. Who is the former Prime Minister of Canada who is well known for his bustly chin?
Jay Leno.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't go away. We'll be right back with Joaquine Phoenix and Mr. Mohino. Welcome back. We'd like to introduce to you now a celebrity guest that's been in fantastic films such as Gladiator and Walk the Line. Please welcome Academy Award winner Joaquine Phoenix.
How you doing?
Good, you? Good, you? Good. Joaquine Phoenix, so how you doing?
Glad.
Looking good?
Thank you.
Use a good razor, I see. It's good, it's good, it's good. So basically, ultimately, America wants to know one answer. And I think you know what it is. It's no surprise. You've been in show business for a long time, big time actor, Academy Award winner. You've won awards in Gladiator, Walk the Line. You're totally removing yourself from that industry and going into hip hop music. Is that correct? Is that what you're saying? Something that you don't know about? Is that correct?
That's about right.
Yeah. Well, folks, we have actually a message from America. Actually, everybody in America actually signed a petition. And I have an envelope that America has sent me, which I would like to show you. You want to take a look right there. Knock, knock. Joaquine.
Joaquine who?
Exactly, stay in acting. No energy. Like, have you played hockey for like 3 hours, or?
Oh, hockey sucks.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back after these messages. Stay tuned. I'd like to introduce to you now a gentleman who's just come out with his first CD ever, called self-debut album, Mr. Mohino, all the way from Mexico City. Mr. Mohino performing My Dog Can't Open Up a Beer Bottle.
My dog can open up a beer bottle with his ass. My dog can open up a beer bottle with his ass. You push it in, you give it a twist. You hear a bark and then you hear a psst. My dog can open up a beer bottle with his asshole.
We'll see you soon. Have a great night. Take care, folks.